Hello, this is Dr. Maria Anwar. Hope you guys are fine. Today we are going to discuss about the adrenocortical hormones. So, adrenocortical hormones are those hormones which are actually released by the adrenal glands. Adrenal glands are the glands which are present above each of your kidneys. We grossly divide adrenal glands into the two parts. The outer parts is called the adrenal cortex and the inner part is known as the adrenal medulla. Now what's about the layers of the adrenal cortex? We divide the layers into the three parts. The outermost layer of the adrenal cortex is known as the zona glomerulosa. Middle layer is called zona fasciculata. And the innermost layer is known as zona reticularis. And the inner part, the most inner part of the whole adrenal gland is known as the medulla. Medulla is different from the adrenal cortex. Here you can see, this is the histology of your adrenal cortex. Here you can see, these are the cells of the zona glomerulosa, then zona fasciculata, and the innermost layer of the adrenal cortex is the zona reticularis. Now these are the cells of the medulla. How about the adrenocortical hormones? Grossly, we divide the adrenal cortical hormones into the three types. Number one, mineralocorticoid. Number two, glucocorticoid, and the last one is the androgenic hormones. So what are the mineralocorticoids? Mineralocorticoids are those hormones which are involved with the regulations of the minerals and salts and eventually water. There are different kinds of mineralocorticoid. The most potent mineralocorticoid is aldosterone. We will discuss it later in our lectures. Another type of mineralocorticoid is deoxycorticosterone. Then there is corticosterone, 9-alpha, corticosol, cortisol, and cortisone. Now keep in mind, though all of these are mineralocorticoid, but only aldosterone has the most potent activity, and then there are other mineralocorticoids, though they do have mineralocorticoid activity, but their mineralocorticoid activity is not as potent as compared to the aldosterone. Corticosterone and 9-alpha cortisol, they are synthetic. It means they are not naturally produced in the body. Now here you can also see the cortisol. Cortisol, though we broadly classify it under the classification of glucocorticoid, but cortisol also has mineralocorticoid activity when it is secreted in the large amounts. Now we move to the glucocorticoids. Glucocorticoids are those hormones which are involved in the metabolism of the fats, lipids, and proteins. The most potent glucocorticoid is the cortisol. Then we have other glucocorticoids, for example, corticosterone, cortisone, prednisone, methylprednisone, dexamethasone. Now all these cortisone, prednisone, methylprednisone, and dexamethasone, these are synthetically produced. Cortisol is naturally produced and it is most potent in naturally in human body. But these synthetic glucocorticoids, for example, cortisone, methylprednisone, and dexamethasone, they are more potent as compared to the cortisol, which is produced naturally. You guys must have known about the different drugs which use the steroid to control the inflammatory reactions. So these are those drugs, dexamethasone, methylprednisone, prednisone. Later on we will find out that they are involved in the control of the inflammation. So that's why they are used in the pharma industry. The last hormone of the adrenal cortex are the androgenic hormone, or you can also call them sex hormones. They are of different types, for example, the dehydroepiandrosterone, androstenedione, estrogens, and glucocorticoids. Though glucocorticoids are broadly classified under the obviously all glucocorticoids, for example, cortisone, but they also have the androgenic activity. No, you guys do have remembered they also have the mineralocorticoid activity and they also have the androgenic activity. Later on, when we'll discuss about the pathologies, then we will see that whenever there is an excess of glucocorticoids or there is a deficiency of glucocorticoids, it not only affects the glucocorticoid activity but also the mineralocorticoid and androgenic activity. Here I take you back again to the layers. Here you can see the zona glomerulosa majorly produced aldosterone, which is involved in the mineralocorticoid activity. The zona fasciculata is majorly involved in the production of cortisol, corticosterone. In the zona reticularis, it is involved in the formation of androgens or the sex hormones. Now, how are adrenocortical hormones are synthesized? Adrenocortical hormones, they need ACTH. ACTH is the adrenocorticotropic release hormone. They have the receptors on the cell membrane, which is cyclic AMP G protein coupled receptor. As you guys have already discussed about the mechanism of actions of different hormones, so I'm not going to the detail, but you know the cyclic AMP eventually produces the protein kinase A. Now I take you to this picture. Here you can see that protein kinase A, it eventually affects on the cholesterol. Here you can see the cholesterol which is present in the lipid droplet. Now that cholesterol is converted into the pregnenolone. Conversion of cholesterol to the pregnenolone is a rate limiting step which is determined by the hormone known as desmolase. Again, I repeat it, ACTH, it has receptors on the cell membrane. Then ACTH eventually causes the conversion of cholesterol into the pregnenolone through a late rate limiting step by enzyme desmolase. Now the pregnenolone, it can either follow this path, 2-progesterone, 11-deoxycorticosterone, corticosterone, 18-hydroxycorticosterone, and eventually aldosterone, which is a mineralocorticoid. Or the pregnenolone can take this part by the action of 17 alpha hydroxylase. It will convert into the 17-hydroxypregnenolone, or then they can eventually form the cortisone, which is a glucocorticoid. Here you can see it is also the cortisone, which is your main major cortisol, and this is a cortisone. So these are all glucocorticoids. Then again, the pregnenolone, it can cause the formation of different enzymes, and through the different enzyme it can form the dihydrotestosterone, estriol, and these are all androgens. Estrogens and androgens, these are all sex hormones. So you can see the ACTH causes the formation of mineralocorticoid, glucocorticoids, and androgens. It forms it through the cholesterol, through the late limiting step from the desmolase enzyme. Now go back to the previous picture again. Here again, you can see ACTH, it has receptor on the cell membrane, which is a G protein coupled receptor, and through the cyclic AMP, it causes the formation of protein kinase A. Protein kinase A, it converts the effect acts on the cholesterol, and cholesterol is converted into the pregnenolone. Then the reactions occur in the mitochondria, and eventually the different adrenocortical hormones are produced, and they are transported back into the bloodstream. Hope you guys understand this lecture. If you still have confusion, you can email me or you can text me. Thank you.